Hey everyone, it's Brian Cookay, and today I'm going to give you the 3 main reasons why the M1 Mac Mini is still the best value for money computer you can buy in 2022, despite it being 2 years old. I invite you to follow through the video as I'm going to mention a certain feature that really improved my days, and the reason why I upgraded from the base model to the one with 16GB of RAM. Also consider subscribing if you haven't already, as I'm fresh in my YouTube journey and it really helps me out. The first reason why you should get the M1 Mac Mini is because of its design. I have to say that I absolutely love how small and compact this machine is. By being just 3.6cm tall and 19.7cm deep and wide, it barely takes any space on my desk, and that helps keep a clean and minimal looking setup. Weighing 1.2kg, it's also very easy to move around if needed, and altogether these characteristics can make it somewhat portable as well. By no means is intended to function as a laptop would, but if you are in need to have a PC desktop that you can comfortably move around, this is a great choice. This also means that you can hide it easily if wanted, for example by using an under-the-desk mount to achieve a really minimalist setup. Another great function that this design provides is the I/O that we have in the back of it. Here we can find a power port, an Ethernet port that you can upgrade to 10 gigabit, two Thunderbolt USB 4 ports with support for displays up to 6K resolution, an HDMI which provides up to 4K resolution, and then we have two USB-A and also a 3.5mm headphone jack. Now, that's not bad at all and can be a game changer to some people, as you have everything you need to connect to a desktop setup. And it's worth noticing that not even the brand new Apple laptops with the new M2 chip supports two external displays at once, like we have on the Mac Mini. It's a really great option to have if you now or in the future plan to have a 2-monitor setup. I also get to save some of those ports for other devices by using my Logitech mouse and keyboards via Bluetooth. Some people say that they experience trouble with Bluetooth connectivity, but so far I haven't had any issue with that at all. Another incredible thing about this design is how silent and efficient it is. It almost makes no noise at all, and that is perfect for when I have to record audio for my YouTube videos, as I will not get any background noise and also basically produce very little heat, even when performing very demanding tasks like video editing. All of this could already justify the purchase, but keep watching as things are about to get better. Moving on to the second reason why you should buy a Mac Mini is the performance you will get. The reason why I bought it in the first place is because I was looking for a machine that could run 4K video editing, as I was struggling with my Windows computer and really needed an upgrade. I first thought about building my own custom PC, but by seeing how huge the final price was, I decided to look for other options, and that's where the Mac Mini jumped in. I have been using the base model for a while, which comes with 8-core CPU and 8-core GPU, 8GB of memory and 256GB of SSD. I managed to edit 4K videos on this computer without any struggle. It runs smooth without any throttle, lag or crashes. Scrolling through the timeline has been a pleasure, both in Final Cut and Premiere Pro, without having the need of using any proxies at all. And the render process has been really fast, especially compared to my Windows computer, that actually has better specs than the Mac Mini. Not only, I often have been doing all of that while having multiple tabs open, and as well sometimes while using Photoshop in the meanwhile. I really recommend going for the base model, since upgrades can be costly. But if you are planning on keeping this computer for a while, it makes a lot of sense to expand the RAM to 16GB, as you will have no way to increase that later on. And that's exactly what I did after a while, as I wanted to be sure that this computer will handle all of the tasks I'm gonna throw at it in the future. Regarding the memory, I just made sure to buy a good external SSD for editing, while I use a standard 4TB hard drive for the rest. If you had to buy a PC for the same budget, you would get nowhere near the performance that you will get with the Mac Mini. And that can be an optimal starting point for switching to a Mac, if you always have been a Windows user and wanna try out what macOS has to offer. Of course, here I'm talking mostly for productivity and work reasons, as if you are interested in gaming, this is not the right computer for that. The third and the best reason why you should buy a Mac Mini right away is the price. This computer, at its base model, can be purchased directly from Apple for $699, and you can also find it discounted on external websites like Amazon, given the fact that it's now 2 years old. Now, the price by itself is incredible considering the performance, reliability and functionality you get for that money, and there is no argument that this is the best value computer in the market at the moment. Also, an extra small reason why I bought the Mac Mini is because of the Apple ecosystem. I am an owner of an iPhone 13 Pro Max that is actually what I use to shoot all of my videos here on YouTube, including this one, and the Mac Mini made my life so much easier. Basically, every time I record a video, once done, I have to transfer it to my PC, so that I can then work on it through an editing program. And before, with my Windows PC, I had to connect my phone to it via cable, and then go through a bunch of different steps to be able to finally have the video in full quality in my computer. That process can be frustrating if done often, and be in the end really time-consuming. With the Mac Mini instead, that is really easy and straightforward. I just had to airdrop it to my Mac, and that's it. I will have the file in native quality on the computer ready to use. I know it's a small detail, but for me it really is a lifesaver, and has made the process of making videos a lot easier and faster. Having that option is so convenient that if you are recording videos with your iPhone, for either YouTube or other, having a Mac becomes unessential. There are many other perks that you get through the Apple ecosystem, and I invite you to try it out for yourself, and let me know in the comments what benefit you got out of switching to a Mac. So, to wrap this up, with the Mac Mini you will get a small, compact, silent and reasonably priced desktop computer that has real power and performs better than some high-end systems out there that are 5 times more expensive. I think that's more than enough reasons to buy this machine in 2022, instead of waiting out for new tech. I hope that this video was helpful, and I invite you to leave a like and subscribe if it was. I will catch you guys next. Peace, Kukei out.